God bless you on this Sunday morning. I want to share with you prophecy for 2017. This is Bishop Penner from the Dr. Martin Luther King Movement from the Seed of Abraham. This is my book, Prophecy for 2017. I want you to be able to get that book. This is prophecy for you. I'm glad to come to hear you on this end. July the 1st. I want to share with you the seed, amen. I want to share some of my prophecy with you. As I share my prophecy, I have a young girl saying that you make a difference. I want you to read the keys, the three keys. Key 1, 419. Key 2, St. Luke 6:38. Key 3 is St. Matthew 11:29. We're talking about prophecy for 2017. This is July, 4th of July coming up. We're going to have a mass chilling that's going on throughout America. And I want to say to you this morning, I'm praying for you, you, and even you. And I want you to know God is able to do anything to fail. Don't forget, this is my prophecy book. You can order this book and ask me for it. And I want to share with you, Mary. I want to, Lucy, I want to share with you. Friends, I'm praying with you. I want to give a word of prophecy. And this prophecy is the prophecy for, I want you to read, Proverbs, this is wisdom, Proverbs 8:12, St. Mark 6:4, Jesus said that he will answer all prayer, St. Luke 4:24, St. John 4:44, St. John 3:34, I want you to get ready for doors to be opened up for you. I want to tell you this morning, there will be storms back to back. And you said, Bishop, what's going on? God is trying to reach out and speak to some of you. I'm praying for you and you this morning, whatever you're going through. Don't forget, we come on 7 days a week. You said 7 days, we come on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, 11 to 12. If you got a need, plant a seed to our ministry, you can go to our website, theseedofabraham.com. As you go to that website, you go down to PayPal and do what you need to do. Or you can write me. You can write me at Post Office Box 28-9097, Chicago, Illinois 606. I want this month to be a blessed month for you. I want you to see. This is the 7th month. The 7-7, the 7 wonders of the world, the 7 mystery spirits, the 7 archangels, the 7 sisters, the 7 brothers. I want to work that 7 for you. That 7-7-7 work for you. I want you to call me, get in contact with me. I want to be a blessing for you. Thank you for listening to my website. Thank you for going to Black Talk Radio. I want to keep giving you inspiration. I want to keep sending you the power of God. As I pray for you, all these services is put together by our staff and our ministers all over the country. And I'm Bishop Turner praying for you. I thank you for coming to our website, coming to Block Talk Radio, coming to YouTube, coming to Bishop TV station. I thank you for that. I want you to know God is able to do anything for you. Get ready for this month to be a blessed month for you. Get ready for you go knowing, sowing, and pouring. This is Bishop Turner. I want to let you know that God got to bless you. Listen to the word as I minister to you. He ministered to me. And I'm going to tell you something about what's going on in the world. But the word of God is key. You got to lift the name of God up. And when you lift the name of God up, you already got a blessing. And that's key. We lift the name of God up. And when we lift the name of God up, automatically it's a breakthrough. When we lift the name of God up. And I'm asking you, wherever you might be, let God come in and let God be a blessing for you. And next, when you next have choices, choices will come and it will break through for you. I'm praying for your breakthrough. I'm praying for your deliverance. Lord, we thank you. And I want to thank you. And I want to thank every letter, every telephone call, every expression of love. I want you to plant that seed. I want to loosen up money for you in Arkansas, Mississippi, and Louisiana. I want you to say, Bishop, I'm ready to be blessed. And I want to be a blessing for you. Look at somebody, tell them you thank and call on the phone, say, thank you. Just begin to thank somebody. Get on your cell phone. Get on that cell phone, say, I thank you. And whoever you need to talk to, tell them you thank them. I want you to thank God for bringing you. I want to say this. I want you to call me. I want you to get in contact with me. This month is the 7th month. I'm moving curses and hexes off of churches, off of homes, off of people. You need to call me. Your auxiliaries need to call. I need to walk through your building. I need to bring the healing and the deliverance that the Almighty God give me to give you. I want you to get ready to plant that seed for the need. If you got a need for sickness, plant a seed. If you got a need of joy, plant a seed. If you got a need for somebody, I want you to get to me. Post Office Box 28909 Chicago, Illinois. I want you to call me at 773-629-0005. Call me. I want to talk to you. Thank you. I want you to tell the Lord I thank you. I want to leave that with you. God bless you. Get ready for God to bless you. You come right now in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Father God, we ask you to touch every man, every boy, every girl. We want to pray during this 4th of July, this month of July, which is the angel Raziel and the angel Michael. We come to tell you your healing is a moment away. Your blessing is a moment away. I want to say thank you, God, for your healing and your grace. As we say that, as I pray, Father God, touch that family that lost loved ones, those that are caught up, those that are sick. Thank you, Jesus. We come in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Father God, we ask you to touch, heal, and deliver every man, every woman right now. God, I know that you're able to touch. We come at this hour to ask you to lift us up in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Father God, we ask you right now as we go out through the air to bless, heal, and deliver. Father God, we know that you're able right now. Touch every boy, every girl, every man. God bless you. I want to thank you, and I want to let you know, go to my website, thecedarabrahamyellowsite.com. I want to thank everyone that are listening by Block Talk Radio, those that are listening to our morning service that come on YouTube. We want you to go knowing, sowing, and flowing, and we want you to know that God is able to do anything but fail. We want this month to be a blessed month, July. Raziel is the angel of July. Get ready and say thank you. Whatever you're going through, it's going to be all right. I want to share with you this month, the month of prophecy, the month of things that we told that will happen. And I want to tell you, as we prophesied to you, that storms back to back, floods back to back, earthquakes, but God is still in control. And I want you to know that this morning. I want you to get ready. Whatever you're going through, I want you to claim your healing this morning. This is the year of the rooster. This is the lunar year. This is the year of eclipse. And Archangel Michael is keeping watch. Michael, Raphael, Raphael, and the angels. Don't forget, I want you to read Psalms 119, east, west, north, and south. Yes, I want you to read it to the east. Then I want you to read it to the west, where the sun rises and the sun set in the west, rise in the east. Then I want you to go to the north, where it bring all physical gifts to you. Then I want you to go to the south, where hurt and pain have come up. I'm asking you to read it four different ways. God bless you. I want you to get ready for a breakthrough. As we bring the word of God to you this morning, as we share with you on Block Talk Radio, we say thank you. And I got the Detroit Mass Choir coming up. And as they come up, we're going to get ready to break the word with you. Just 5 minutes. We're going to talk to you. And don't forget, Block Talk Radio every Sunday from 11 to 12. But as we get ready to bless, thank you, Champ, Dr. Chris, now you. I'm on my Block Talk Radio right now. I'm doing my YouTube service right now. I'm glad to have you on. And I want to say to you, you had a wonderful show last night. And I enjoyed your show. Your show was real. I had a couple of calls, and they said your show was entertaining. And I want you to let you know they enjoyed your show. And I want to say, and that was good. And it's a lot going on this 4th of July, going into the 4th. The angel this month is the angel Virgil, along with Michael, and Muriel is the month of June, and Virgil is the angel of July. And they tell me there's going to be a lot of energy going on and a lot of things happening in this month. And I was trying to get it out to the people that God is still in control, and there's going to be a lot of things revealed. They've been covered up all the year. But this year is the lunar year, and the year of the rooster means family's gonna come most close together and things gonna break out. I wanna tell you, I've been praying for your brother. I hooked him up with Mr. White. He said he's an ordained bishop. I wanna get him to work. I wanna get him a church down in Mississippi. I want to get him started to serving God. And one of the key things, you got to leave flesh alone and go to spirit. And once you get into spirit, you break yoke. And we're talking about getting into spirit. See, right now, when we stand up for God, God's going to make a yoke. And don't forget to call back at Block Talk Radio, okay? Yeah, he will take care of you. And God is able to do anything for you. There's no failure in God. I want you to get ready for God. That's a Matico record that did that. But I just want you to get ready for God to bless you. For God to open up a door for you. And sometimes you got to wait on for God to give you a special blessing. And God got a special blessing for you. And sometimes you got to stop your complaining and let God help you out. Reverend Paul Jones saying, I won't complain. I want you to know that you had some bad days and some good days, but you shouldn't complain. God is able to carry you over those hills, and he's able to, that worry is, let God touch you. I want to pray right now. Father God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Father God, I'm praying for somebody don't know their way out. I'm praying for that wayward boy, that wayward man. I'm praying for the healing right now. Father God, I know that you're able to touch, heal, and deliver. Father God, I ask for your healing spirit. I ask for your breakthrough to come through right now. Every letter, every telephone call, Father God, I know that you're able to do anything but fail. And I'm asking you right now, God, to come in, touch, heal, and deliver. Break yokes. Father God, I know that you're able right now. And Father God, if you just let go and let God, bless that man, that woman, those that are in the mental institutions, those in the hospitals, those that are incarcerated in state facilities, and those incarcerated in federal facilities. I'm asking you to touch them right now and turn some things around. The God of Abraham, my healer, my deliverer. I'm asking God to touch, heal, and deliver right now. I know God is able to do anything but fail. And I'm asking God to touch, heal, and deliver right now. I know he can, and I know he will. I won't complain. Bad day. I won't complain. I can hardly see the road. Come on now. I still question why. Why so much pain? But I like to say this thing. This is Reverend Coleman. Good for me. All my new eyes can't see. I want to say thank you, Lord. Just say thank you, Lord. Say that. Thank you, Lord. Yes. He's so good to me. He really, really been good to me. Have he really been good to you? He have turned my midnight. He really been good to me. The world could ever know. Say that. Been so good. Me. Come on. He turned my midnight. He turned my midnight. My midnight. He just dried him up. Somebody know what I'm talking about. My midnight. In today, turn my midnight, the darkness, he turned into today. I want to say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for the healing, for the deliverance. Thank you for the breakthrough. Thank you. Somebody know what I mean. Go on, Brother Paul. Say it. God is good. Thank you, Lord. Those that read the Bible, and I want to say to you that read your Bible today, this is, and I want to say to you and you, God is able to bring you out. And I want to let you know, if you just let God, let go and let God, God can do anything but fail. There's one scripture I want to share with you today, and you might read that scripture, and he's my light and my salvation. And I should put my trust in him. And I want to talk about, Lord, help me to hold out. And right now we're going through something. We got to ask God to help us to hold out. And Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob asked God to let them hold out, that you might be able to hold out and go through what you're going through this morning. And I want to say to you that have problems, I want you to keep continuing, telling God to help you to hold out. And it seems like your end ain't going to come, but I want you to ask him to help you to hold out. And when he help you to hold out, you're able to reach out and help somebody else. It might be God, but you ask him to help you to hold out. And we're going to the Mississippi, Detroit Mass Choir, and I want them to sing that for you. Somebody help me to hold out. And you ask them to hold out. And some of you need that. And this is a friend of mine singing that song, Help Me to Hold Out. And this when he was much younger and didn't have no church. But he had one of the biggest churches in this country. And if you ask God to help you to hold out, Maxine, Lena, ask him to hold out, Brother White, Dr. Christian, ask him to hold out. And if you ask him to hold out, Lord, ask him to hold out. And I'm going to let you know God will help you to hold out. I'm praying for you that are locked up, those that are sick, those that got loved ones in their family. You asking God to help you to hold out. And I want to tell you, God's going to help you to hold out. And I want you to know all is well. Get ready, but God's going to break a yoke for you. And I want to, this is your season. This is your blessing. And you let God present for you. The blood of Jesus cover you, your healing. You'll get dark. But I'm asking God to open up that door for you. And I want you to get ready for God to deliver you and bring you to another level. It just said, Lord, help me to hold out. Whatever you're going through, I'm going to let you know. And God can help you hold out. I'm praying for you. Mayor Hawking, I'm praying for you. Pearl, I'm praying for you. I'm sure I'm praying for you. Mayor Scott and Tony Scott, I'm praying for you. Sherry Nicholson and Henrietta Nicholson. The whole Nixon family down in Western Louisiana, I'm praying. Mama Joe, I'm praying for you. I'm praying for you, Bishop Ross. I'm praying for you, Bishop Moore. I'm praying for those that are in the spirit world and those that are in the physical world. My word is, help me, Lord, to hold out. Help me to endure what I'm going through. I wish I had somebody. I want to tell you, Mary Bly, it's going to be all right. Surely it's going to be all right. God is carrying you through. But God wants you to know, if you just hold out, he's going to help you be all right. Mother Misi used to say, help me to hold out. And I want to tell you, whatever you're going through, the Lord help me to hold out. If you can hold out, joy come in the morning. Breakthrough come in the morning. So all the ancestors saying, just hold out. You know, we're dealing with racism, white supremacy all over the country, but you ask God, the Almighty, to help you to hold out. And you can finish school, you can finish college, you can get that degree. You can go north, south, and flood in the right direction. Lord, help me to hold out. Help my family to hold out. Somebody need to say that. It seems like you want to throw in the towel. It seems like ain't nobody on your side. But I want to tell you that Almighty God in you said, hold out. Joy coming in the morning. Lord, help me to hold out. Now, if you can hold out, you can help somebody else. Right now, this is the Detroit Mass Choir saying, Lord, help me to hold out. And he can help you, body, mind, soul, and spirit. He can help you to hold out. Sister Francis, I'm praying for you. Brother Frank, I'm praying for you. And all the ancestors, I'm calling for all of them on this July. And I want to let you know, in the astral, in the physical world, in the spirit world, God is love. For God so loved the world, let me help you out. For Amun-Ra so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son, he gave me and you to heal and be delivered. So Lord, help me to hold out. I want you to hold out this morning, because joy and success is coming in your business. Whatever you're trying to do, you're going to be successful in the job. You're going to be successful. God, just hold out. Somebody say, help me. The Spirit help you to hold out. It's going to be all right. Body, mind, soul, and spirit, help me to hold out. The chain is coming. Lord, help me. The chain's going to come. I want to thank you, Bishop, for that. Now, if you know that Bishop voice, let me know. Somebody ought to know that voice. God bless you, Bishop, until my change comes. Until my change comes. Change coming. Just hold on and let it come. Lord, help me to hold on. I want to thank you, Mississippi Mass Choir. I want to thank you, Georgia Mass Choir. I want to thank you, Detroit Mass Choir. Lord, help me to hold out. Young lady, you can hold out. Young man, you can hold out. Help me, woo, to hold out. Because joy coming in the morning. Peace coming in the morning. Love coming in the morning. In the morning, joy coming. Get ready for joy. Lord, help me to hold out. Somebody said, Lord, help, I feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Let me pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, touch, heal, and love. Somebody need to hold out. Bless that boy, bless that man, that woman right now. God, I'm asking for your healing. East, west, north, and south, around Mississippi, Arkansas, Louisiana, Georgia, Texas. Lord, help them to hold that family, Lord, that lost loved one. That family from China that lost their daughter. Lord, help them to hold out. The God of Abraham, the God of Jacob, God, help us to hold out. Help us to help others. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name, touch, heal, and deliver right now. Walking up the King Highway. I'm on my way. Woo! Woo! What will you do? I want to say to you, I'm on my way to heaven. What you going to do? I'm praying for you and you. Come on. It's a highway to heaven. Love and peace up there. Come on, say that, choir. Say that. It's a highway to heaven. All my melanated folks, all my melanated ancestors on this 4th of July, there's a highway to heaven. Good God Almighty. Thank you, Mama. Thank you, Papa. I just want to thank those that was in the trenches, those that died in Vietnam and Korea. There's a highway to heaven. Get on the highway. Get on the highway. Highway to heaven. See Jesus. Yes, get on the highway. Get on the highway. Yeah. Get ready. On my way to heaven. Hey, I'm going uptown. I'm on my way. This is for you, Sister Gladys, Sister Hill. This is for you, Sister Betty Herman. This is for you, Sister Betty Williams. Sister Betty Claudine, I'm praying for you, Claudette, Claudine. Sarah, for you. I'm on my way to heaven. It's a highway. It's a highway. And the word is God. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. It's a highway to heaven this morning. And I want to say it to you. God bless you. Open up the door. What Prophet John said, in all thy ways acknowledge God. He will direct your path. And Reverend J. Uptop said, wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Preachers that code and prophet, you just said. Reverend Cobb said, reach up. Make no difference what you think about me, Brother Dove. Make a difference what I think about you. I cannot let jealous, envy, or nothing separate me from the love of God. And I want to say that with you. God is able to do anything but fail. And I want to let you know we are praying for you and you this morning. And whatever going on, God already got your back. And whatever you think happening, God has already got your back. God has already opened the door for you. So get ready for God to bless you. Get ready for him Sunday morning. Somebody said Sunday morning. I want to say Sunday morning, say it tonight. See, Friday night we go out all night, but early Sunday morning we in church shouting. And I want to say Sunday morning, say it tonight. Sunday morning, people got healed. Sunday morning, they came in drunk, but they left healed. Something about Sunday morning, they sing them Dr. Watts song. Somebody says Sunday morning. Come on. Sunday morning. I want. And then that preacher get up and he said, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. And somebody break out Sunday morning. Somebody, Lena, what time is Sunday morning at 11 o'clock? It's my healing. Sunday morning is my breakthrough. It's Sunday morning in July. It's Sunday morning in April. It's Sunday morning in August. It's Sunday morning in September. But Sunday morning, something happened on that Sunday morning. You got up on that Sunday morning. God healed your body. Somebody said, Sunday morning, I come and come to the altar and say, Lord, forgive me for my sins. Sunday morning, something special about Sunday morning. Grandma shouted all over the church. Papa sung that old hymn, Sunday morning, it's like resurrection. All in the African American community, all in melanated community. Somebody said they don't know what happened. You go in the church all sad, but Sunday morning you come out resurrected. Crucifixion bring about the resurrection. Somebody says Sunday morning, I went in sick, but I come out well. I went in blind, but I come out see. I went in limping, but I come out walking. Sunday morning in the church, the little church way back in the woods, you have to walk across the river to get to the church. You got to go over the levee to get to the church, down the road, around the curve. But Sunday morning, when I got there, I was able to get my doctorate degree. I was able to be a doctor, to be a lawyer. Sunday morning, I got resurrected. Somebody else said, Sunday morning. Glory. Hallelujah. I'm praying for you. God bless you. Come on. I'm gonna let it shine. That grandma used to sing that song. Come on now. Yeah. Why don't you? Sunday morning, come in the house. God bless you this morning. This is Bishop Turner with the House of Prayer. It's Bishop Turner with the Seed of Abraham. Bishop Turner with the House of Miracles. Bishop Turner with the House, the Palace of Divine Love, the Temple of Almighty God. Our churches in Detroit, our churches in Mississippi, our churches in Louisiana, our churches in Texas, Church St. Paul, Divine City Church in Minnesota, wherever you might be, we're praying for you. And what you know, God is able. As they sing those songs of Zion, get ready for God to bless you. Hey, I want to shout this morning. Don't make me shout. God bless you. Hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down, friends don't treat me. Hallelujah. Glory. I laid my burden down. They said, friends don't treat me like they used to. Friends don't treat me like they used to. Since I laid my burden down. Hallelujah. Let me leave that alone. Something to be with Jesus.